In Cuba, the scope of Hurricane Ian's wrath is now visible.
In the fall of 2022, Hurricane Ian destroyed parts of Florida and knocked out power across all of Cuba. The hurricane made the headlines, but the power and water shortages happen daily in Cuba.
The shortages in electricity and power in Cuba have caused an uproar from the people of the island. You need water to produce clean energy, but you also need a lot of energy to produce clean water. 4 billion people around the world face water scarcity issues. That means that almost half the world faces these problems.
José Carlos Díaz hopes to find a solution to this global crisis. He's a University of Michigan chemical engineering PhD student, and he grew up in Cuba.
I think the most striking thing as I was growing up was the fact that there was a lot of issues with electricity. Doing the homework was usually with candlelight because the government would constantly shut down the power to save a little bit more energy. As a small kid, I usually think about, oh, what if we created a battery that would last maybe like more than 24 hours so that during the night we can have some energy, some electricity. I play around with small batteries and try to understand it, but I was far away from building anything like that.
Ahora no tiene la reja esa, ya no está ahí.
In 2011, 15-year-old José, his 5-year-old brother, and their mother escaped from Cuba.
It was my mom who decided to flee the country. She saw that our future there was not gonna go very well.
I was thinking, I want better life for my son. I want different life to me.
And in the middle of the night, you know, 2 a.m., 1 a.m., I think it was, we got into a car, went to one of these speedboats, basically, and we took off. It was almost like a horror movie, like I didn't know what was happening.
The smugglers took the family to a port in Mexico, and after a couple of weeks there, to the U.S. border. At the border, the family asked for a political asylum. The Diaz family settled in Miami, where José faced new challenges.
Now, all of a sudden, I have to start in high school, late, in now a high school that spoke another language that was not the language that I spoke. Very, very tough moment for me, yeah. My first class was biology, and I had a keen love for biology. And there I found some sort of like a safe space because, again, science didn't really have a language for me in a way. So it was easier to just look at the books and see what they're trying to explain. So through science and through going through the biology class and trying to use the microscopes again and trying to talk to my teacher and then chemistry class too, that's how I started learning English and then becoming a little bit more proficient and less scared to talk to other people.
José went to a community college in Miami, then to Johns Hopkins for his undergraduate degree, and finally to the University of Michigan for his PhD.
At the University of Michigan, I worked with Professor Jovan Kamche from the Chemical Engineering Department. Our research is based in understanding the transport or how different molecules move in polymer membranes. These membranes are important for applications like batteries, for example. They're aqueous batteries that can power grid-level houses and cities. But also our lab focuses on desalination. We also focus on these types of filters, these membranes that can selectively permeate water to one side while the ions are kept on another side, and then you get fresh water. Being able to desalinate water from available resources, like seawater, for example, taking seawater, then passing it through a filter and then getting fresh water, that's important for, you know, a lot of people in the world. Especially like islands like my country, Cuba, where I come from, where there isn't a lot they can do to get fresh water.
I think so far we've done some pretty promising work, and we actually do talk with industry quite a bit. So Jose actually has one patent that we submitted, a patent application. We're on the process of commercializing some of the membranes.
Coming to the United States, it has been an amazing experience. I realized the countless of possibilities that I have now. Basically, my mom's dream was for her two children to have as many possibilities as possible for them to study whatever they wanted and to do whatever they wanted in life. My hope is that through my research and my outreach events, I can offer a little bit to this community, to the United States, basically. A little bit of my intellect, as this was, you know, country by choice, as a lot of us immigrants say.
Leave Cuba was the best decision in my life.